What's going on, everybody? This is Needham Tucker. Today, we're going to look at the XG 750 from Sophos. This is the mothership when it comes to their firewall product lines. This is the largest appliance that they sell. We're installing two of these for customers, so we're going to take a look at this today and show you what's inside. Stay tuned. Hey guys, welcome back. I'm Needham Tucker, owner of Katori Technologies. I've got over 20 years experience in the IT industry, and today we're gonna take a look inside this box. We have got in here an XG750 from Sophos Firewalls. This is the top of the line appliance that you can get from Sophos. This has got all the bells and whistles that you could get. We'll go over the specs here in just a little bit, but let's take a quick look inside to see what's inside this thing. This is a big box. I mean, this thing's heavy. I mean, it's solid. So we're gonna take a look at this, guys. Give me just a second. All right. Okay, guys, we're gonna take a look at what's inside of this box. I've got my trusty knife here, and take a look at this guy. Unbox it. Gotta be careful, don't wanna cut anybody, especially myself. Take a look here at this guy. This is a big box, guys. If you're putting one of these in your network, you are on some serious firewalling right here, buddy. All right, so these are double boxed, actually. So we're going to open the first box here. We're going to pull that guy out. Whew, give me just a second, boy. This guy's big. So I'm going to tilt this guy up. Look at that. Go back underneath. Not hurt our backs. We got to do the whole suction technique for the boxes. Cut a little air hole in there. Beat up there, guys. Didn't mean to beat the microphone up as much as I did. Careful with your knife, guys. Like I said, this thing's big. This is no joke, guys. This is no joke. Okay, so here's the interior box. Again, Sophos logo. Nothing too special about this box. But this is the inside one here. Whew, kind of winded. There we go. All right. This is it. Oh, that looks pretty, guys. That looks pretty. Let's take a look at this here real quick. Inside the box. I'm gonna tilt this guy up just a little bit for you guys to take a look at what's inside the box right here. So this is it. You got your rack rails. Power cord again. Another power cord for the redundant power supply. We've got your other rack rails here. And then again, all of that. So let's unbox this bad boy and see what's on the inside. After everything else is done. We're just going to take this whole top part out. We'll set that aside. Now, we've got this thing. Guys, this thing's no joke, so be careful. Don't want to drop this or anything like that. So I'm going to come up underneath this guy here. Pull this guy out right here. All right, so inside the box, there's yet another box. This is like the other Sophos box. Let's see what's in here. Again, with all the unboxings, we've got the quick start guide, LAN modules. These are for the FleXi ports, how to install those in the system. Safety instructions, those are important. Make sure you pay attention to those in your area. Sliding, this was kind of hard to get out. Sliding rack rails insulation there. Got the Sophos orange cable, the console cable for managing through the console. It's good they included that one that way. And the other ones, some of the other ones, they've got the USB modules. Inside of this box, looks like we've got the rack ears to hold on to them, to pull them out from the front on the rack rails. And then the screws are in that box. And then what have we got here? Next piece here, serial numbers for your documentation purposes. Some more screws. Not sure what those are. We'll take back a look at those. And then some, I guess some feet if you weren't planning on putting this in a rack. But guys, I really hope you guys are planning on putting this into a rack. That'd be a little crazy to get this guy and not put him in a rack. So I'm gonna put all that stuff up real quick and take a look at what's in the box. The actual bag inside this beast of a machine. This is our moisture control system there. MCS, I guess you could call it. Moisture control system 5000. All right, be really careful with this, guys. These are not cheap. These are not cheap by any means. Okay, so you guys can take a look. We're gonna move this away so we've got some more room here. All right, so now we're back. Let's take a look at the front of this guy. As you can tell, the system does not ship with a whole lot of modules. You have to buy these. These things are highly customizable. Our customer has actually purchased 4 10 gigabit FleXiport module for this guy to connect into their infrastructure. Two hard drives here listed, and a RAID 1 array. Again, you've got your USB connections. Again, remember these guys, this installs here with a Linux module to install in the operating system. You got your control here. Then we flip around the back. We've got your redundant power supplies, your fans, VGA connection, your power on and off, and this is an add-on card for later to be used. All right, so we take a look at this. We've got, this is an 8-port, 1 gigabit interface card. It's got your lights on the front here as well. Management 1, management 2 interfaces. These are for out-of-band management interfaces for your system. And at the very front, you see this A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. These relate into the actual module bays on the for the FleXiport modules, so you'll know where your different bays are plugged into in reference to. Again, same kind of interface that you have on the front of these guys as most of your Sophos is with the LEDs. There's really not much that's changed as far as that goes. Okay, so I had to get a screwdriver here to show you guys these modules and how they unscrew, or how they, not necessarily unscrew, but how they come out. So we're gonna unscrew this. This gives permission, or I guess allows this piece here to go down, and then they just slide out like a standard power supply would come out of any server type system. You guys can see the back of that, what that looks like. Again, really well constructed, guys. Sophos takes a lot of care in when they build these systems and what they put in place. I'm gonna screw that guy back in place here to make sure that it does not fall out during installation. We would not want that. Again, like I said, we've got the system here. If we unscrew this here, we're gonna actually take a look on the inside. This is actually the first 750 that we've installed. We've installed some bigger ones before, or smaller ones than this. This is the first 750, so this shall be interesting. All right, guys, you'll notice that there's two screws here and here, and these are to take the cover off. Again, don't suggest doing that. There's another screw here, but as we slide this guy around, you'll see this other screw hole here, and this one says that if this is removed, it voids the warranty. So don't do that if you want to keep your warranty, and I would suggest you'd want to keep your warranty on the box like this. All right, so let's get this guy powered up, and let's take a look at what it looks like when it powers up and what it sounds like. Okay, guys, it's time that we power this beast on and take a look at how loud she gets. Here we go. Oh, she's screaming about something. Let's see what happens here. Let's see, Sophos protect. There's a button back here. I'm gonna turn the alarm off real quick. I saw that red button earlier. That turns the alarm off on this guy while it boots up. Listen to it. It's taken off. Okay, guys, we're back from powering this guy on. We're gonna take a real quick look close at the menu and take a look at what we've got here in just a second, all right? Take a look here. You can see this is what pops up on the system here. Nothing really happens until we hit the actual enter button. When we hit the enter button, we actually get the main menu. As before, on the Sophos's, the network menu, the primary menu, the firmware, HA information, and those are the primary, the menus that we've got here. You know, if you go into the system menu, you get things like the date and time, the uptime of the system, the CPU, memory utilization, load average, the disk, live users logged into the system, and that's what you get. Escape out of that guy, go down to the next menu here. We've got the network menu, enter. Again, show port A1. Again, this is A, if you guys take a look here on the system here. This is module A, port A1, so you can see what that port configuration is. And this goes all the way to port A8, sorry. And then go there. So we're gonna scroll, show all the ports. Port A3, those, and again, it only shows the configured ports. So the other ports are actually off, so that's why that is. Network menu, that's what we were just in. The firmware version, again, shows you the actual system firmware. Show firmware, enter here. MR6 is the actual release number, 17.06. Escape. Factory reset the device if we wanted to, shut down the machine, or reboot the machine from here. Oh, I don't want to, I'm going to escape, I don't want to reboot, sorry about that. Bad idea in a server room, make sure you keep your server rooms locked. Okay, HA information, no HA is configured, so really don't have that. And that's it, that pretty much, you know, is kind of what we, like we said before, what we have on all those guys, so... that's your kind of your menu screen for that guy. Today we're going to take a look at the inside of one of these Sophos XG FleXiPort modules. This particular module is a 4-port 10 gigabit SPF Plus module without bypass. Now the bypass basically means that it will allow, if the firewall fails down, it will fail open if it was bypass was enabled. This is without bypass. So we'll take a look at this guy, open up the box. It's a pretty simple box here, styrofoam. Open up this guy, standard module. We're actually gonna plug it into this guy in another video, but I just wanna open this guy up so you guys can see what it looks like. A little, you know, nice packaging. We've got LAN module configuration guide inside here. It looks like a safety manual or a safety guide, and then a quality assurance piece. But if we open this guy here up, take a look at what's inside the box. All right, we've got this here. We'll take a quick close-up look here. Okay, guys, this is a close-up look of the 10 gigabyte SPF Plus module for the Sophos XG 750, SG and XG 550 and 650 as well. You guys take a look at, there's four ports, 1, 2, 3, 4. Your lights are on the top. Your two screws to screw it in. If we turn it sideways here, you'll see the board, what it looks like there. And then that's it, guys. Just gonna plug it in here. Okay, so you just gotta make sure that we know which module we're gonna install into, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. For the purposes of this job that we're doing, we're actually gonna put this in module H. So you unscrew the screws here, pretty simple. Kind of unscrewed them a little bit for you ahead of time so you wouldn't have to watch me unscrew screws. And then we're going to slide this guy in. There's these rails here slide on to little rails inside of there. Slides in place, plugs in like that. Screws in here. Again, it screws in just like it unscrewed. Secure these in here with a screwdriver, give it a nice little tightening there. Don't strip the screws, of course. And then at this point, we can plug this guy in. And the operating system should pretty much detect everything. So we're gonna plug in, you're gonna hear a beep here. Well, it boots up here. There it goes, I'm gonna turn that off. Fantastic. All right. And what we'll do is that we'll take a look when this guy gets booted up and we'll show you where this shows up in the interface module on the display. All right. Okay, guys, she's booted up now. We're gonna take a look at the interface window here. And we're gonna hit the enter button. We're gonna scroll down until we see the network menu and hit enter again. And then we're going to see port A1. This is just asking if we want to see the IP addresses, but what I want to show you is just how they all show up inside the system. So I'm going to hit show all. This is going to show us the interfaces. So this is the guest AP LAN pre-configured. This is port A1, the LAN port. This is the WAN port not assigned. This is A3. Next we're going to go to A4, A5. A6, A7, A8. Now that's the last port here. Sorry, the last port here on the device here. You can see that there. Next, the system is going to switch over to H1. So there's H1, H2, H3, and H4. Again, not assigned. And then it's going to go to management 1 and then management 2, these two interfaces. So that's the XG750 with the 10 gigabit SBF Plus module specifically for this device. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I really enjoyed putting this together for you guys. Make sure you hit any comments below if you've got any questions or what other kind of videos you'd like to see us put out there on these Sophos modules or some of their technology you'd be interested to see. Make sure you like us, subscribe, hit the bell notification to let us know so you get notified of the next time we put a video out. You guys take care and have a great one.